My name is Chris Looney. I'm a diagnostic radiologist here at Heartland Hospital in St. Joseph, Missouri. I went to medical school at the University of Missouri in Kansas City. And then following medical school, I did an internal medicine internship at Southern Nevada Memorial Hospital in Las Vegas, Nevada. Then I did a four-year radiology diagnostic residency in Columbia, Missouri at the University of Missouri. Then I did a year of interventional radiology at Northwestern University in Chicago. And I did a year of neuroradiology in Salt Lake City at the University of Utah. What a radiologist does, he's the physician, the medical doctor, that interprets x-rays. We read CAT scans, we read MRIs, ultrasounds, and then regular x-rays that you would get if you hurt your foot. You know, the salaries of physicians are pretty much all over the board, and a diagnostic radiologist salary is somewhere around the probably the 50th to the 70th percentile of all physicians. Probably the average salary is probably $200,000 a year, I believe is one of the last statistics I saw. Radiology technologist is the individual that takes the x-rays or helps with procedures. If you're a technologist, you have an opportunity to take between a 2 and a 4 year training program after high school. Whereas typically a physician does 4 years of college and then 4 years of medical school. And then in my case, I did 7 years of postgraduate training. So after high school, roughly 15 years of training. To be a technologist after high school, you go to various schools, anywhere from 2 to 4 years of training. And their job is to interact with the patients, get the patients into the exam room and take the chest x-ray or do the CAT scan, and then prepare that so it can be interpreted. If you're a technologist starting out, newly trained, you might expect a salary of say $30,000 to $35,000 a year. And if you've been here for maybe 15 or 20 years, you might expect a $50,000 or $55,000 salary. There are some big cities, Atlanta, New York, Chicago, that have a relative shortage of technologists, and their salaries would be substantially more competitive, maybe even double what you might find in the Midwest. But a lot of that, you have to realize you're living in a large city, things are more expensive, and the work wouldn't be much different. But it would probably be a little bit more difficult or a hassle, so to speak, to live in a major city, or in my opinion. Well, thank you very much for watching. I hope you are all entertaining the idea of a career in medicine. Again, this is Chris Looney. Thank you very much.